Those early morning starts, sun's not even up yet, but I think it's gonna be about 20 degrees today, so it should warm up a little bit later. All right, I've just finished up work, so I'm thinking I'm just gonna smash out a quick hour shoulder session, but got my pre-workout here. Mr. Hyde, what's this? Cotton candy flavor. This shit tastes amazing. And then I'm gonna add a scoop of agmatine in there as well. Yeah, I got them Flyknit Racers on today. These are like the lightest shoes in the world.
You look like wearing little slippers.
I haven't trained shoulders at Fitness First in a while, so while I'm here, I might as well take advantage of the Smith machines, of all Smith machines. Well, I just did my first warm-up set, and I was looking in the mirror thinking, whoa, got some striations coming through. Starting to get a little bit leaner now. Loving it. Start my first proper working set. Now the reason I like to do Smith machine presses over like a dumbbell is because it's a lot more sturdy and you can really focus on the down phase. I find that you get a lot of tension built up on the joint when you can focus on that eccentric movement, and then you just squeeze it back up, pump the blood in there, and then yeah, just keep it moving. Man, I haven't felt a burn like that in my shoulders in a while. I love doing the presses first. Forgot how good it feels. Oh. I'm gonna do a couple more sets on this and I'm gonna move on to my next exercise. I just finished up my fourth set on that, and as you can see, I probably only got like 6 to 8 reps on those, but I was just really focusing on that down phase, loading up the front of the delt as much as possible, and then squeezing and holding at the top of every rep. So now I'm gonna move into doing my front raises and just focus on finishing off that front part of the delt, and then I'll do the sides and the rears later. In terms of the tempo, I'm bringing it up nice and strong, then I'm sort of catching it at the top and then really controlling that down phase to try and build up as much time under tension. Okay, so next movement. I'm gonna superset the dumbbell laterals. So now I'm trying to focus on obviously the sides, bringing up that roundness, and then I'm gonna do it with a wide grip upright row. So this is one of my favorite supersets, because when you hit those upright rows after you do the laterals and you're already a little bit tired, it just pulls right here where the shoulder connects to your arm, and you get mad roundness to all through the side here. So let's get it.
Yeah.
Okay, so take home tips for that one is that hold it loosely in your fingertips, try not to grip it too hard. And then when you draw up, bring your elbows up above the bar and have it about this far out in front of your body. If you're pulling it in towards your neck, you're just gonna use a lot of forearm action. So you wanna use your delt to pull your elbow up. Try it. So I'm feeling pretty spent up doing four sets on that. But what I'm gonna do now, it's not over yet. I'm gonna hit a one arm dumbbell lateral superset with the front raise with the rope. A lot of superset to keep the shoulders because it keeps your heart rate up. Keep the blood in their muscle. Moving on to rear delts now. So as you guessed it, I'm doing a superset. Starting off with a dumbbell, one arm fly. So it's a very isolated movement just to try and get the joint warmed up, put some blood in the muscle, and then I'm supersetting it with a rope face pull. A lot of people seem to skip over these kind of movements, but I feel like if you bring up your rear delts, it will really add some thickness to your shoulder and just the overall look of it as well. So I try and hit at least two or three different exercises on this. Just finished up four sets on that, and my rear delts are feeling pretty good. I'm actually surprised with how much they're popping today. Okay, now because I'm a little bit of a goose sometimes, I brought my meal bag from home and forgot to grab meals. So I got an empty bag. So I'm gonna go out and get some lunch, probably grab some sushi or something. But lucky I brought a protein shake. Got a scoop of my banana flavoured WPI. International protein. Taste like bananas. Oh yeah, and because Cassandra's a bit of a goose, she forgot her hair straightener at a photo shoot last week. So I have to go get it for her. Oh, shit. Poverty meal at its best, but it's actually not too bad. The sushi from 7-Eleven. How cool is that heads up display, navigating me to where I need to go? I've got the hair straightener. All right, time to head back to work. Yeah, 1 p.m. and I'm already finished work, finished for the day. So I'm gonna go see my osteo now, get my lower back work done because it's still a little bit sore. And just wanna really get this thing fixed for good now. And it's been about 3 weeks that I've been feeling pain, so. Thought, you know what, I gotta go see a specialist and get this shit taken care of. What, you think I'm not gonna get a Coke Zero from 7-Eleven on the way? Alright, so I just left my osteo and I feel so good. I love getting therapy because you walk in there all stiff, can't bend over, and then you walk out feeling amazing. Yeah, just got home and finally get to have a proper meal. Cracked open a Pepsi Max. Watching a bit of Judge Judy. Some midday TV, huh? Beautiful. Oh, I literally just passed out on the couch for like an hour. I just laid my head down and I was zonked. I was just out. And then I woke up and I was like, shit, we need bananas. We gotta go to the store. So we're gonna go run to Coles real quick and buy some supplies. And we've just been online trying to search for that Amino Energy coffee caramel flavor. And everywhere is sold out. Every single supplement website in Australia sold out. What is going on? where can I buy this? Right, we just got to Lygon Street in Carlton, and we're gonna go to the Coles and buy some groceries. And then I thought, hey, well, let's go out to dinner tonight. So we're at one of my favorite restaurants, Universal, and we're just gonna get a bite to eat. That's it, man.
Oh, look, it's focusing on you. Who's prettier?
Alright, so we're just at dinner and we ordered up a storm. What do we get? Milkshakes? Whoa, let's start with the drinks.
You just asked me.
Alright, what do we get?
Milkshakes, honeycomb milkshake,
butterscotch milkshake.
Butterscotch milkshake.
And garlic pizza.
Garlic pizza. Chicken parmesan.
Chicken parmigiana. Chicken wings. What else?
I'm not eating those. And I don't know.
And spaghetti, no, fettuccine marinara with seafood. Well, that's what marinara is.
We were supposed to go to the grocery store and then we ended up, and then we were gonna get ice cream and now we're here.
The plans changed quite a few times, but it's for the better because we're getting milkshakes. And I love milkshakes. I love milkshakes.
I love milkshakes more.
What are you doing? That's my milkshake.
No, that's mine.
That's my milkshake. Chocolate and what? This, what's this one? Caramel? Butterscotch?
I don't know.
I don't know, man, but these milkshakes are fucking head.
Oh my god.
What is this?
I'm gonna have a try that. That's hectic.
First up, garlic pizza and chicken wings.
Crunchy.
I hope you didn't get anything else.
Shrimp. I love shrimp so much.
I love shrimp so much. Mousy. We finished it all off. Look at that, it's all gone. Yeah, nah, not really. We're getting takeaway. We couldn't quite finish it all. Those milkshakes got me good. Just filling up the beast for the very first time.